Good afternoon, everybody, and thanks for joining us here on the web. We start with the weather. No doubt about it, fans and air conditioning units will be working overtime all across the state today, but that's not the only way to stay cool. Ray Brewer was out there, and he has more.
Nearly 5 o'clock Tuesday morning, and the thermometer gave an indication of what might be coming. The promise of possible record-breaking heat has forced some to change their habits.
It's been warm, but it's been warmer this afternoon.
Did that cause you to go out earlier in the morning?
Absolutely. Or? Very early.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stop!
At the Challenger soccer camp in Concord, young players were getting their exercise in under the watchful eye of their coaches.
We are making sure that they get lots of shade when they are having their drinks, and we are making sure that they have lots of sunscreen, and they're making sure that they pace themselves.
The sun was out at the Concord airport. The official temperature is kept at this station, and at 9 o'clock in the morning, the temperature was approaching 80 degrees, affecting even aircraft. The Concord airport has an elevation of 342 feet, but with the warm weather, it's comparable to an airport with an elevation of 1,900 feet. Elsewhere in the capital city, others escape the heat by doing yoga with a twist.
This is our paddleboard yoga class.
Concord believes they're the first park and rec department to offer yoga on the water, a way to strengthen your core and keep cool at the same time. And Tom Warner admits as the temperature climbs, he thinks about joining in.
Looks pretty tempting. I know I and both my supervisors would like to try it out sometime, but with the work schedule, it makes it kind of tough.
And now, one of the hottest places in the state is expected to be Nashua, where to help residents out, they will be keeping their pools open for an extra half hour, closing tonight at 8:30 instead of 8. Keene police say a man pretended to have cancer so that he could bilk people out of thousands of dollars. Officials say 26-year-old Logan Henry was accepting donations through a website titled Help Logan Henry. He told people he needed help paying for cancer treatments, but it turns out he's been out of work for a shoulder injury and never had cancer. Officials say he has promised to reimburse anyone who donated. Two people under arrest after an elderly woman is reported missing from her home in Massachusetts and then found in West Ossipee. Police say the 80-year-old showed serious signs of abuse and neglect. Her son, Darren Brown, and his wife, Sharon Giordano, are charged with criminal restraint and criminal neglect of the elderly. They are due in court this afternoon. Police say the couple could face additional charges. A man accused of robbing a bank in Salem earlier this month has been arrested in Massachusetts after police received tips via Facebook. Police say 26-year-old Joseph Costello of Lowell, Mass. Is the man you see here earlier this month at the Citizens Bank inside Shaw's. Officials say he demanded money and claimed he had a bomb and a hostage. Costello was arrested after allegedly robbing another bank in North Andover. And police say after they posted pictures of him on Facebook, they were able to track him down. Starting tonight at 5, those temperatures continue to rise here in New Hampshire and across the U.S. A look at the dangerous dry conditions many people are facing right now. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.